A barge whose deck is 10 feet below the level of the dock is being drawn in by means of a cable attached to the deck and passing through a ring on the deck. On the dock. When the barge is 24 feet away and approaching the dock at 3 volts feet per second, how fast is the cable being pulled in? Okay, so first we're going to draw the picture. So we're going to draw water like this. We're going to draw the boat. Okay, something like this. Not the best picture of the boat. Okay, so now let's see. The deck is 10 feet below the level of the dock. Okay, so the dock will be here. Okay, and this is the deck. Right, so this is D. Well, both are D. Well, I'll just say point A and this is point B. Okay. We can actually use it with a different color like this. Okay. So we have this. And then we can create a right triangle. Okay, and this is 10. So now let's see. So we can indicate this as X, we can indicate as Y, and this is gonna be the hypotenuse, AB. So now let's read the keywords. So 10 we marked already, passing through a ring, when the barge is 24 feet away. So X is equal to 24, right? Approaching the dock at 3/4 feet per second. So it means that the distance from A, well, let's label this as C. Okay, so AC, AC is 24, but the distance is decreasing because the boat is approaching. Okay, the boat is approaching the dock, right? So this distance from A to C decreases with time. So for this reason, since X represents the horizontal distance here, the rate is going to be with respect to time, right? dx divided by the dt is equal to 3/4, but here's where you got to be careful. You see, the barge is approaching at 3/4 feet per second. So the distance is decreasing at the rate 3/4 feet per second. So for this reason, it has to be minus sign 3/4. Okay, because the distance from A to C is decreasing as the boat gets closer and closer. Okay, so now what are we gonna find here? How fast is the cable being pulled in? So it means how fast, it's basically telling you what is the rate at which the AB is decreasing, right? That's all that the question's asking you to do. So we need to before I say find, let me actually write AB as D, okay? Distance. So now we have to find the rate at which this D is decreasing. So I'm gonna label this as D, okay? This distance. So now we're gonna find dt. That's exactly what the question wants you to find. Okay. So now, in order to find dd dt, you have to relate the regular d before you differentiate both sides implicitly with y and x. So for this reason, we're going to use the Pythagorean theorem. So x squared, as you know, plus y squared is equal to the hypotenuse squared, which is going to be the d squared. If you differentiate both sides now implicitly, and you can differentiate both sides with respect to time, because that's the fourth variable, right? You already have three variables, x, y, and d. The fourth variable is the dependent variable. That's going to be the time, right? Okay, I'm sorry, that's going to be the independent variable t, right? Because time is independent, so it's going to be So x and y and d will depend on time. So now we're going to differentiate both sides implicitly. We're going to get 2x times dx dt, right? Because treat this as a tail. Remember, this tail for every variable will appear if you differentiate that variable with respect to some other variable, right? Plus 2y times dy dt, once again, because time is different than y, right, is equal to 2d times, once again, tail for the d, for the distance, because d is not time, it's not the t, dd dt. So now let's see what we know. We know the x, that's 24. We know that dx dt is negative 3/4, so I'm going to indicate this with one color. We know this, we know x, we know y, right? Do we know dy dt? Let's see, what is dy dt? Dy dt is the rate at which the distance from C to B increases or decreases. But does it increase or decrease? It's a duck, right? So the distance from the sea level to the duck is going to be the same. Right, because nowhere in the problem did it say that the sea level is rising, right? So dy dt is equal to zero. It's not affected, right? So dy dt zero. Do we know the d? We don't know it, but can we find it? Yes, because we can use the 24 and the 10 to find the d using the Pythagorean. So let's do that. So using this equation, we're going to substitute x with 24, y with 10, and solve for d, right? So d squared is going to be 24 squared plus 10 squared. So that gives us, let's take the square root already. So square root of this sum, and square root of 24 squared plus 100 is 676, and that gives me 26, right? So that gives me 26. So that's the d. We found the d. So guess what? We can easily find this now. What the question asks us to do based on all other variables that we know. All right, so let's plug it in. 2 times 24, that's the x value. Dx dt is negative 3/4 plus 2 times 10 times dy dt. Why? Dy dt is 0, so it cancels everything out in that second term, times 226, right, that's the d we just found, times, and I'm going to indicate this with another color, dd dt. That's what we need to find. So as you can see, this guy turns to 0. And here we have 24 divided by 4 is, let's have 2 cancel out with a 4. It gives us 2. 24 cancels out with 2. It gives us 12. Right? So 12 times negative 3 is negative 36. So we have negative 36 plus 0, so that's, we can disregard that, is equal to 52, right? 52 times dd dt. So now dd dt is basically going to be negative 36 divided by 52, and what is that going to be? Negative 18 over is that going to be 26, and that's going to be negative 9 over 13. So that's the rate at which the cable is being pulled in. And notice that the answer is negative. It's negative. And the negative makes sense, right? Because the distance from A to B, that's the d value here, is decreasing, right? Because the boat is approaching the dock, so it makes sense that AB is decreasing. That's why you have the negative result. Okay, so if you want to put it into words, your final answer, you're going to say cable is being pulled in at 9 over 13 feet per second. And notice I'm not using the negative when I put it into words, because it doesn't make sense to say pulled in at negative 9 over 13 feet per second. Right? We're already implying the negative because we're saying pulled in. You see, this is where you have to be careful. When you put it into words, notice that pulled in takes you back into the word problem kind of format. right? When you're talking about pure mathematics, you will have to write the negative because the word pulled in is not there anymore. Thank you so much for watching this video, and I'll see you in my next one.